Welcome everybody to my show, the Movie Cabin of Dr. Mike Face, and I am Dr. Mike Face. This is going to be a very special episode. It's my first collection video. I've only done movie updates, stuff that I bought throughout the month or so, but this is a very, very special one. It's going to consist of my entire collection of Batman memorabilia from the 1966 show. I got everything. I got Blu-rays, DVDs, bobbleheads, action figures, comic books, posters, one I have right back here. And last week when I heard Yvonne Craig passed away, which it's tragic because there's not very, very many cast members left from the show, and really hit me that I have to make this video. And this is going to be a dedication to her, to Yvonne Craig as Batgirl. You rock. So and then this is something I've been wanting to do for a long time, and this is something that I've been obsessed with since I was a kid. I used to watch it on Fox when I was a kid, and then in middle school, 2005-2006, it ran on Nick at Night, and then, it was premiered on Nick at Night, and then it was on TV Land. And then I just never really left my system. I just really, really loved it. I've had the movie up until last year. Fox and Warner Brothers ever finally came to a freaking agreement. To release it on DVD and Blu-ray. Thank God it freaking happened. I thought I would be a freaking old man by that time. Never since then, they've released so much stuff. Action figures, comic books, all this. It's a dream come true. So I'm very, very happy to do this, and I hope you guys enjoy it as well. So I am Dr. Mike Face, and this is my show. First up, we're going to start with the VHS, DVDs, and Blu-rays. And I have Batman the Movie on VHS, and I've had this since I was about 6 years old, and this is my first piece of memorabilia. This is the oldest piece I had. Everything is the oldest piece, and right here, this is this is a gem to the entire collection. This is the seed, the root that grew. And the story about this tape, I'll give you a little story. When I was six, this was sitting in Blockbuster, and I had my dad rent it. And then after a week, and we bring it back and rent it again and again and again and again. I just kept pestering my father. And then eventually Blockbuster went ahead and just sold us the tape because we rented so much. So this is the very, very tape that I first saw this movie. Right here. Freaking awesome. Awesome artwork, too. I really, really dig it. And see how it's owned by 20th Century Fox? Freaking awesome. So that's pretty much why, for years, you can get the movie and not the show, because Warner Brothers and Fox owned the TV series, and they were in a big old financial struggle, especially with the William Dozier family as well. But here it is. Batman the Movie on VHS. Next, I have Batman the Movie on DVD. I also purchased this before the existence of the TV series on Blu-ray or DVD. And this is a pretty good DVD set. It came with an insert. I got this used at FYE, one that I used to go to all the time. Now it's now closed. It closed about 2 years ago. It's a shame. Not too many special features, but I really, really like it. The artwork is not as cool as the VHS. I would have preferred it that way if they kept that, but they changed it. Oh, well, but I've seen worse editions. I've seen one when it's just the Batman symbol red, trying to make it look modern. I don't really like it. I like it when they try to advertise that this is an old, campy style show or movie. So here it is, Batman the Movie on DVD. Next, this is a very, very rare gem. I spent like, I think, $50 on this. This is Return to the Batcave, starring Adam West and Burt Ward. Julie Newmar is also in it, and Frank Gorshin, who played the Riddler, is also in it. And this was released by Anchor Bay. This is one of my pride and joy Anchor Bays. And this is kind of a spoof, but it's also kind of like a biopic movie. And I've shown this in one of my updates. And it's about Batman. It's about Adam West and Burt Ward. They get invited to this car invention where they show the old Batmobile. And somebody steals it, and they're on this adventure trying to recover who found it. Who stole it, not found it. They were trying to find it. And they do a lot of remembering, reminiscing about their time on the Batman show. And they have, like, people reenacting them and, like, everybody. And it's really, really fun. It's a lot like the show. So if you like the movie, you like the show, and you've never seen this, this is really, really cool. It came out, I saw this when it aired on TV. I think this, 2005, I was 15 when this came out. Right around when the show, that was probably why the show came back around that time to, like, advertise for this movie. It's pretty, pretty cool. So, Return of the Batcave, starring Adam West and Burt Ward. Up next, give me a second. This is Batman the Movie, the Blu-ray Comic-Con Special Edition exclusive. I saw somebody's video, and I saw this, and I didn't know this even existed. In that moment, I had to buy it. Went on eBay, bought it for like $40 to $50, I think I spent on it. And it's really, really cool. It's got when I saw Cesar Romero's face on it, like as the Joker, I'm like, whoa. Because I just really, really love Cesar Romero as a Joker. This is just really, really nice. I'm very, very glad I went ahead and bought this. It's such a nice set. Comes with the sleeve. I'll even take it out. I haven't opened it yet. And I haven't watched it yet. I gotta get around to it. But it's cool. Comes in a black case. See how it's brand new. The artwork is just super, super cool. Especially planting Cesar Romero's as the Joker on the cover. So freaking awesome. Up next. Is the limited edition complete Batman television series. Let me see if I can cram it in there. Freaking awesome. I'm not going to open it up and go through it, but it's really, really cool. It's loaded. Has all the episodes from season 1, 2, and 3. Has loaded with special features. Since I bought it last year, I didn't pre-order it, but I bought it immediately when it came out. I bought it like November 1st. And I just, I was so excited for it. Like I've been waiting for this to exist for years. And I think it's very, very beautiful set. And the remaster, they look really polished. The episodes are just so awesome. So, very happy I bought this. And it was worth every dollar. I spent like over $200 on this because this was brand new when I bought it. But it's gone down a bit. It's still really, really cool to have. This is my pride and joy of my Blu-ray collection. So, here's Batman, the limited edition Blu-ray box set. Up next, I'm going to show you my comic books. Up first is this is from the 66 Batman 66 comic book series that just this is brand new. Batman meets the Green Hornet. It's a sequel to the episode from season 2 of Batman meets the Green Hornet. This is really, really cool. The artwork especially is amazing. Great likeness. Here's the spine. And along with Batman, I'm a big Green Hornet fan as well. I enjoy the show. Van Williamson as Britt Reed, aka the Green Hornet, and Bruce Lee as Kato. I really enjoy that show in a way just as much as Batman, but it's not as nostalgic to me. But I really, really like it. It's just really hip and retro. I just can't, just beautiful. And I read this through, and Kevin Smith, who you might remember him, he played Silent Bob, and he also directed all the movies with Jay and Silent Bob, and Clerks 1 and 2. He's a pretty good director and actor, and he had a lot to do with the creation of this series. I really, really like it. The dialogue in it is very, very on par, especially with this one, on par what you think they would say from the TV show. It's just really, really well done, and the artwork is phenomenal. And the villains in this one is the Joker. He teams up with not Colonel Gum, who was originally played by Roger C. Carmel. In this, I don't think they could get the likeness from Roger C. Carmel, so they kind of reinvented him. He's General Gum, and he has a mask, and it's pretty, pretty, pretty cool. And like I said, the likeness is perfect, and the dialogue is awesome. So yeah, Kevin Smith. So here's Batman 66 meets the Green Hornet. Up next, it's from the same series, Batman 66. This is the lost episode with Two-Face. I think the original, this is from the leftover screenplay and script from the guy who actually wrote an episode for Two-Face, but I think the character was just way too scary for the child audience, so they kind of scrapped it. But the creators of this tracked down, they found the original writer. I can't remember his name. The original story by Harlan Ellison. So it's pretty, pretty cool. The likeness. I definitely like the Batman meets the Green Hornet a lot more than this, but this one was pretty cool. I kind of wish the because it was rumored that Clint Eastwood was supposed to play the Two-Face. I kind of wish that he went with the Clint, got the likeness for Clint Eastwood and made him look like that. But either way, I really, really like it. The color scheme for his clothes and stuff was pretty cool. It's an alright one. Next, this is Batman 66 Volume 1. And I read some of this. I haven't got through it yet. I definitely didn't like it as much as Batman 66 meets the Green Hornet. But this is okay. It's volume one. It comes with all the comics into one graphic novel that were released from that series. And I definitely want to get volume two. I definitely want to get volume three. I wish I got this in a hardcover. I just saw this at Barnes & Noble, and I had to have it. So one day, I think, I'm definitely going to get the hardcover, and this is the one I'm going to read, and the other one I'm going to take care of. So Batman 66, Volume 1. And last but not least for the comic books, this is not a comic book, but it is a book. And this is kind of really old school. My mom bought me this for my birthday. I think this came out in the 80s. This is the official Batman Bat Book. It's by Joel Eisner, and it has everything you want to know about the Batman show, like everything possibly. It goes through every single episode in grave detail, like writers, actors, characters. Pretty freaking cool. I'm not going to open them, just trying to really preserve this one. So sorry about the glare. So the official Batman Bat Book. Up next, I'm going to show you my action figures and I have one bobblehead, so. For the action figures, I'm going to film it a little differently than I did with the movies and the comic books. So, first up is the Batmobile. This is by Mattel. I don't know if I'm pronouncing it right, but it's pretty freaking awesome. You had it at Toys R Us for I think I spent like over $60 on it, and I kept it in the box. I don't really have. It's really well detailed too. Sorry about the glare. You got everything. Got the bat phone in there. Everything. And this is something that I wanted as a kid, but it didn't exist. I remember writing down on my Christmas list, "Oh, I want the old school Batmobile action figure with all the Batman, Riddler, and everything," but they didn't exist. Here's some artwork. Some really cool artwork. Here's the back. And everything else from that toy line. I really, really love this toy line. I was really, really excited when they made these. So here's the Batmobile. And this is another really, really special three action figure set. I have all the individual ones, which didn't consist of Batgirl up until this year, or Robin. And Robin you can only get Robin through the Batclimb set, which also came with Batman. It was very, very hard to find, very, very rare, so I never got my hands on it. I thought I was like shit out of luck for getting Robin. But then about 3 weeks ago, I heard about this set, and I just had to get it. And it came with, as you can see, Batgirl. It's pretty cool. Batman, which I already have, but it's so cool. There's Robin. They even have little windows. Can't see too well with the glare. The back is pretty awesome as well. With all the description, and it always advertises the other characters that are in that toy line. I really, really like this, and I'm really, really glad they made this. And I'm sure now that Yvonne Craig is no longer here, this is going to be pretty pricey. I paid like $60 for it. And they also released a Batgirl by herself, but that was like more than this set, so I just went ahead and bought this set. Pretty awesome. So, Batman, Robin, and Batgirl. And up first for the individual packs, this is the Joker. It's a pretty, pretty cool looking figure. And as you see, I've had this since last year. And this is the first one that I bought. It's really, really cool. You can even see, the likeness is pretty freaking awesome for that scale. And you can even see, maybe you could see, even it has the mustache, like Cesar Romero did on the show. It's kind of like his calling card. He would never shave it, even for the role of the Joker. So they just painted over it, which they did with the action figures. Pretty cool. Cool artwork. I really, really like it. Like I said, it's a dream come true to even own these, all the description. It's always cool to come with their own little description, backstory, whatever you want to call it. As you see down there, it has all the other action figures in that toy line. So there it is, the Mattel's the Joker action figure, and this is the Riddler action figure, portrayed by Frank Gorshin, and this is the second one I bought. When I bought the Joker and I saw
that I was leaving Riddler behind. It killed me. So I think I went back the next week and bought it. It's really, really great detail, great likeness. Really love Frank Gorshin as the Riddler. I hope they continue making more of this series and they make like a special John Astin Joker. He played the John Astin Riddler. He played the Riddler in season 2. He was very, very famous for playing Gomez Adams on the Adams TV show. Really, really cool. Great likeness. Wish I could show you more in great detail. It's little Riddler symbols that run up and down his leg. So awesome. So that's that. The Riddler by Mattel. And here is the Penguin, who was portrayed by Burgess Meredith. Once again, sick likeness. I bought this after I bought the Riddler. When I first originally bought the Joker and then the Riddler, they didn't at Toys R Us, they didn't have Penguin and Catwoman. I thought they were all sold out. But a couple weeks went by, and I decided to check it out, and there it was, the Penguin. And I was really, really excited. I bought it right away. And I bought it along with another one that I'm going to show real quick. So there's that. The Penguin, portrayed by Burgess Meredith. And here we have Catwoman, portrayed by Julie Newmar. That's the likeness that they got from, because I know she was Catwoman was played by two other actresses, Lee Merriweather in the film and Eartha Kitt in season 3. But I have to say, I like all three Catwomen. I really do. But Julie Newmar is my favorite. I really like her chemistry with Adam West's Batman. I thought they were more to the characters and how they not realistic, but it felt natural, I guess. They were very not very discreet on their feelings for each other. I really like it. This is a really good likeness. That's Catwoman on the back. Pretty cool. So here it is, Catwoman, portrayed by Julie Newmar, and action figure by. And here we have Batman, Surf's Up Batman. This is a pretty, I thought this, when I was aware of the entire toy line, I thought this was very offsetting. I'm like, Surf's Up Batman? Because they didn't have a Surf's Up Joker, but I'm like, where's Robin? Why can't I have Robin? Because Robin only exists in the Batclimb special Batman action figure set. So it's like, oh, damn it. It's like, well, you made Surf's Up Batman and not Robin. But it's still pretty cool. It was another one that I still had to have. On the back, there's a backstory about the episode near Batman. It's pretty, pretty cool. The likeness is great. The bat board and the bat swimsuit. Pretty, pretty cool. And once again, portrayed by Adam West. So here it is, Surf's Up Batman by Mattel. And we have here Surf's Up Joker. And for a while, the series just consisted of Batman, Joker, Riddler, Catwoman, Penguin, and Surf's Up Batman. And like I said, it was off-putting also because they didn't have Surf's Up Joker, but I guess they held off on this one for a little bit. So this one took a little bit time to come out, and I'm glad they freaking did because I just love the Joker. Pretty cool likeness. The board's pretty on par, except for the Joker face. I remember in the episode, the face really did look like Cesar Romero, where this one's a lot more cartoonier. I still like it, and the bathing suit's pretty cool. So that's that. Surf's Up Joker by Mattel. And last but not least is my Cesar Romero Joker bust, bank bust. You can see there's like a little slot there. Put your money in. It's pretty cool. The likeness is all right. I find the face is a little off, but it does have the mustache. And I think the profile view is pretty good in the hair. I don't know. I just find it a tiny bit off, but I still really, really, really like it. I still think it looks pretty cool. The detail on the gloves are pretty cool. Got the buttons. Got his tie. Got his little flower. His collar. It's pretty cool. I bought it. It was cool. It was on the floor at FYE Games, and I'm like, oh, I'm going to buy this. Pretty cool. And here's a bobblehead. I bought it at this cool little store called Wild Bill's. It has a lot of movie posters and a lot of bobbleheads. And I saw this. And I had it again. I got it last year. I do wish to complete this collection of these bobbleheads. It comes with Catwoman, Batman, Robin, and they have like a Batman and a Batmobile. Those are pretty cool. I think I'm going to get the rest of those as well one day. A little bit of dust there. I think this has a lot better likeness to Cesar Romero than the Bank Bus does. But it's still really, really cool. I'm glad to own them. So here it is, the Joker Bank Bus and the Wacky Wobbler Joker bobblehead. There's a little mini poster, 11 by 17 poster of Yvonne Craig. I've had this for about a year. I hope, because I really, really love all the characters. Look at it. She's gorgeous. Come on, Yvonne Craig, Batgirl, come on now. But I'm hoping to get more of other. This is not an original. This is a reprint. But I do hope to get other, because I just really, really love the show, of other characters like Vincent Price's Egghead. David Wayne as Mad Hatter, Roddy McDowell's Bookworm. I'm hoping to get publicity, little 11 by 17, little pictures of them, little publicity shots. I just think the show is so cool. I decked my whole room out as Batman classic TV series. It's pretty cool. It's in a nice little frame here. And this is my original, I was told, from 1966. This is the movie poster for Batman the movie. It's pretty, pretty awesome. And this, I guess, was originally a European, an English-European movie poster. As you can see here, like color, spelled C-O-L-O-U-R. We do not spell it that way. We drop the U. Pretty freaking awesome. I bought this for $150. The artwork is just prime. And I don't have any of the credentials to prove that this is an original, but the guy that sold it to me, I trust him. Even that, it doesn't even matter. I would never sell it. I'm going to keep this with me until the grave. You got all your actors. You got Lee Merriweather as the Catwoman. Get closer. Cesar Romero as the Joker. Burgess Meredith as the Penguin. And Frank Gorshin as the Riddler. Pretty nice freaking poster. It's freaking huge. Your regular size movie poster. I bought this about 4 years ago. And I've had it ever since. It does have a little bit of a water damage on the top, but it's still really, really nice. And if it is an original, I think it's in pretty good condition for what it is. Pretty dope. So that was it. This was my entire Batman classic TV series collection, and I hope you guys enjoy it. And if you have any requests for other collections, I do have a lot more. I just don't collect this, I collect other stuff. And other memorabilia for other movies and TV shows as well. This just was happened to be my pride and joy. And I'm really, really glad I made this, and I had a lot of fun making it. I hope you guys enjoyed it as well. And don't forget to check out my friend Dr. Gonzo Boogie's videos. I'll leave a link to his YouTube page in the description below. So you guys have a nice day.